What's the worst job you had?
Worst job I ever had?
Yeah. What, it was just that, coughing?
Well, I had to collect up. It was a very difficult job. I had to collect up every year, financial year, you know.
Every year? April, whose year did you collect up?
Yeah, April to April.
Yeah.
Pardon. All the phlegm, well, Winston Churchill had gobbed out into his bucket by the bit.
Oh, God, yes, I was offered that and job, but I said no. I said, I'm not going to collect all that phlegm because he has so many cigars, so much brandy. I am not, as a human being, going to go around with buckets collecting that fucking phlegm. I said, I'm not going to touch it. I said, I won't touch it. I'd rather be a destitute.
The trouble was, he used to take bogeys in secret. You see?
What, he had them in a cupboard which no one could see?
He was a secret bogeyer. He used to have bottles of the stuff. I used to collect it up for him. I never realised that he was, in fact, taking it overnight.
And then blowing it out.
And then blowing out in the fucking morning. I mean, you didn't know where you fucking were. I came in the morning, there was the same fucking bogey on the bedspread. I thought, fuck me, I only collected this one last night. And there's the cunt lying on the fucking bedspread again, you see. And I thought I was seeing things. I had a feeling of deja vu.
Well, it must have been tricky for you, because I remember hearing stories about Winston's bogeys, which were unbelievable, because, you know, he could produce a bogey as big as the Titanic.
You know why?
He threatened Hitler with it.
You know what happened?
He threatened Hitler with it.
Well, the bogey that was as big as the Titanic was, in fact, the Titanic. Did you know that?
This is what I heard.
Yeah, the trouble...
Well, I've never had it confirmed.
Well, this is... Now, keep it very quiet.
Keep it very quiet.
But the bogey that Winston had that was like the Titanic was, in fact... There was no such fucking thing as the Titanic.
So people went to
People thought it was a Titanic, but it wasn't.
They went to see Winston's bogey.
Yeah. And the fucker sank. And why not?
They played on.
Well,
the violinist kept playing while the bogey sank.
The trouble is, you see, bogeys are not really seaworthy.
Well, I've always...
Winston was a cunt.
I've always said this. You cannot float on a bogey. Don't try to cross the ocean on a bogey, otherwise you're sunk. And who took any notice? Fucking nobody took any notice.
And all those...
I'll tell you who took notice.
Who?
Fucking nobody took notice.
Right.
That's why I'll tell you who took
notice.
You're
fucking right, mate.
Yeah, nobody took
fucking
notice.
Fucking no one.
No one took notice.
All those cunts.
All those cunts. Trooping
out of the fucking
bogey. Winston's bogey. And what happened to them?
SS fucking bogey.
They fucking sunk,
right,
didn't they?
Fucking cunts.
Yeah.
Right.
So, the next time you see a travel brochure saying, go to Mallorca...
On a bogey.
Forget it, mate. Forget it. Because that is the fucking end of the world. Would you excuse me for 1 second while I light up a cigarette? It's more than 1 second. Would you mind not moving your stool?